So what? That's not enough to stop us.
Electric shocks may have helped my blood circulation. Not yet. I still need to get better.
All right! I can't stop! I want to get stronger!
You can totally do it!
Never stop improving.
All right. Not bad.
We finally beat some sense into it.
Just another easy battle for yours truly!
If we've learned anything from Celsius and Volt, it's that Spyrites are tough customers.
They're just as strong as the Great Spirits.
We were wondering when you'd show up.
Interesting. I never expected to find you here.
So you've come to Olympias after all.
I'm assuming you're the one that activated Volt. I don't understand your motive, though. Were you testing its potential?
Potential? I would never entrust my people's lives to something as tenuous as potential. I attempted to tether with a Spyrite precisely because it is something you would consider.
What?
But it was for naught. Their power is far beyond human control. That leaves us with no choice but to eradicate every last Spyrix from this world.
So that really is your plan?
Don't you realize what would happen?
We would end the Otherworld Reactor plan once and for all. Surely the end justifies my means.
What about the schism?
We will leave it in place. As long as Spyrixes exist, the threat of Olympias exploiting Risa Maxia remains.
And what of Maxwell? Do you plan to leave him where he is?
It is the duty of the strong to ensure that the weak do not perish.
This isn't right, Gaius!
What about it isn't right? We will safeguard the schism until the last Spyrix is destroyed. Then, we shall unite the two worlds.
What about all the people who will suffer if you eliminate their Spyrixes? Are you just going to ignore them?
Don't worry about the poor suffering humans. Gaius will protect them.
Jude, Mila, you of all people should understand the ideals I'm striving for.
What's the point of ideals if you force them on others? Don't you see what's happening? Spyrex is a necessity for these people. Take it away and they'll have nothing left.
Jude.
You talk only of possibilities. I demand certainties.
Maybe you're right, but I can't give up.
This conversation is pointless. Please, let's be off.
Yes, I suppose you're right.
What should we do now?
In the end, I couldn't. No, there are still things we can do. There has to be.
Balin? Balin!
Huh? Alfred!
It appears the elevator stopped working when the power went out. We must find some way to get them out of there.
Let's try climbing to the elevator.
Wait! We can use Volt!
How? Wait, you can't be serious.
You're not planning on tethering with it, are you?
Is that really wise?
Maybe not, but it's worth a shot. Only way to find out is to try. Volt, lend us your power.
No way, it worked!
It's still stuck. We need more power.
Please, just a little more.
This must be the same backlash that hit Gilland. Give it up, Jude.
Not yet! What are you doing?
Why do you insist on doing such reckless things by yourself?
Look who's talking.
Hey, don't leave us behind now!
If a task cannot be done alone, then we must simply do it together.
Keep trying and something's bound to stick sooner or later.
And we want to help too! Uh-huh.
Thanks, everyone.
Almost there. Focus.
Now!
Thanks for the save there.
Balin, who are these people?
They're patients. Each one of them has a condition that makes it impossible to live a normal life, even with Spyrexes.
Wait, does that mean the next generation Spyrexes you've been researching are...
Yep. Those little critters they're using are Spyrites.
These creatures are Spyrites?
They're so cute! But they don't seem any more powerful than lesser spirits.
Of course not. They're lesser spirit Spyrites, after all. Wait a sec. Are you telling me you don't know how Spyrites are made?
Do us a favor and assume we don't.
Well, you should ask one of the other engineers if you want the full spiel. But in simple terms, you've all seen spirit fossils, right? If one of you Rizomaxia folks pours mana into one, voila! A Spyrite is born from it.
How strange.
I guess there's multiple uses to those fossils, huh?
The only catch is you need a booster.
What? Wait, did you just say booster?
Yep. If someone with a booster pumps mana into a spirit fossil, the calculatrix art inside takes physical form. And that's how you make a Spyrite.
How are they different from Spyrexes?
It's a matter of art precision. These Spyrites can be as precise as the Aspyrexis devices from back in the day.
I didn't expect to hear that name here.
Uh-huh. Too bad Aspyrexis devices consume spirits.
Does that mean Spyrites don't kill spirits when they're used?
Pretty much. They're fueled by the mana stored inside spirit fossils, after all.
One thing I don't understand. These people seem to have no trouble using Spyrites. And yet, we struggle to tether with Volt.
Spyrites made from great spirits are in a whole different league. The more powerful the base spirit, the lower the chances of a successful tethering. We're still just at a 50% success rate.
Hey, but that's more than enough!
At that rate, lesser spirit Spyrites might completely replace regular Spyrixes someday.
Then people won't suffer and spirits won't die either. We did it! Great job, Cheapo!
Hey, what are pals for?
Does this mean that Olympias' environment might recover too?
It just might.
Thank you, Balin. You have no idea how much this helps us.
You're welcome, I guess. But we really should be thanking you. You're the ones who saved our research, after all.
We did.
If you hadn't saved us, all of our Spyrite research would have gone up in smoke. Someday these people will be able to get on with their lives again.
Something tells me this Spyrite research is going to become very important.
Looks like we found the path we've been seeking.
Yeah, although the fight's not over.
Balin, could you tell us the exact spot where you found us?
Oh, of course. I found you all collapsed at the end of Rusal High Road. You can reach the high road by following this passageway here.
Now Gaius will have to listen to us, right?
No. It's too late. I don't know why I know this, but that was our last chance to convince him.